Hey folks, it's Jim from The Movie Went, and today I'm reviewing the dark comedy After Hours, directed by Martin Scorsese. The film follows word processor Paul, played by Griffin Dunne, who meets a woman named Marcy, played by Rosanna Arquette. He hits it off with her at this cafe, he gets her number, and he plans to meet with her later that night at her apartment for a late date. And things go terribly wrong. He loses his money on his way over to her apartment. He finds things about her that he doesn't really like, and he has to deal with her eccentric, weird roommate, played by Linda Florentino, who's also a sculptor, and he tries to bail and go home, and he hits one obstacle after the next. The subway fare is now higher, now that it's past midnight, and he doesn't have the money he needs to get home. He also bumps into this mob who are after these burglars, and they suspect that he might be one of the burglars. He has to deal with a boyfriend of a suicidal girl, and it's a very interesting and different film from Martin Scorsese. It's slightly more accessible than some of his stuff, and at the same time, it is a dark comedy. It goes into some really dark and uncomfortable places, sometimes very funny places, but this film was not initially well-liked from audiences, and it was one of those films that kind of developed a cult audience. On closer observation, though, I have to say the 80s were a unique, different, and interesting time in Scorsese's filmography. He had The King of Comedy, After Hours, The Last Temptation of Christ, and even a more commercial effort like The Color of Money, which gave him more leeway to do something like The Last Temptation of Christ. I think After Hours was supposed to be that more commercial hit, but as I said before, it was kind of a divisive flick. But it's a movie that takes place all in one night, and it's brilliantly acted from a cast that aren't really Scorsese regulars. Griffin Dunne is absolutely terrific. The guy goes through hell and back. Rosanna Arquette is really weird and eccentric and funny. Same with Catherine O'Hara, who's great in everything. You have John Hurt as a bartender. You have Terry Garr as a waitress. You have Will Patton, who shows up for like 30 seconds. If you blink, you'll miss him. Cheech and Chong show up briefly. Not as Cheech and Chong, but as burglars. The film is really entertaining. It moves along pretty well. I think it runs a little bit out of steam, but the last 10 minutes are pretty damn good. It almost goes into some really, really dark place, but then it kind of cops out. But then again, the way the ending ties in with the beginning of the film is really unique and interesting, and I think that's a very fitting ending. I love the score from Howard Shore. I think it's got also a terrific soundtrack. The photography is gorgeous. It's a really well-made, well-acted movie, and I can understand some comparisons that people make between this and The Book of Job, because some of Scorsese's films do have a lot of religious tendencies, and that comparison, I think, is pretty valid. If you want to see a movie, though, that is like The Book of Job, watch A Serious Man. I think that's a much funnier film than this, but this is a funny film. It moves along, it's very entertaining, and it's also just a really unique and different film, and I think it's aged pretty well, and at the same time, it does feel kind of quintessential 80s from Scorsese. I would watch it without thinking it's your usual Scorsese picture. That's it from The Movie Wine. Have a good day, folks. Until next time.
They're all trying to kill me. I mean, I just wanted to leave. You know, my apartment, maybe meet a nice girl, and now I've got to die for it, you know?
What do you want from me? What have I done?
I'm just a word processor, damn it.
Is that all there is?
After Hours, when anything can happen, and usually does.
Is that unbelievable or what?
That's all there is, my